Hello, it's the third episode of the Mr. The Kid Show with Mr. The Kid, and I'm your host, Mr. The Kid. Today we're going to the Pec Thing on Winnebago County Fairgrounds. This was May 16th and 17th. They have it twice a year. Next one's coming up September 19th and 20th, 2015, Saturday and Sunday. So this should be up just in time for you to go check it out if you're close by. It's at the Winnebago County Fairgrounds. You can go to winnebagocountyfair.com and see it. The dates and everything. It's 19th and 20th, Saturday and Sunday. They recently raised the admission from $3 to $4. Big deal. Children 12 and under are free. Parking is free. It's rain or shine. Basically, the whole fairgrounds is antique and flea market vendors. You'll find all sorts of things from refurbished furniture, antiques, books and records and comics and toys. Got farm tools, got taxidermy. Just all sorts of everything. There's stupid crafts. There's cheap liquidation junk. Anything you're looking for, you probably find something there. There's outdoor tables and tents vendors. And then there's some indoor area on the fairgrounds, the big shed barn things. This last time was, I don't know, I've been 6 or 7, 8 times or something. Yeah. Let's check it out. What do you say?
Sounds good, Mr. The Kid.
Mr. The Kid. First thing we got upon arriving was some puzzles for a quarter apiece. The old dude said all the pieces are there because he puts them all together himself. This hamster driving a truck, or in the back of a truck, is for my wife because it's cute. So is these guinea pigs. She says it's not as cute, but she loves guinea pigs.
I don't like the long
hair. Huh?
I don't like the long hair.
You don't like the long hair. This one was on top. Right? My Little Pony. Two Barbie and the Rockers. Look how cool that guy is.
I got power to show you that was.
Yeah, I'm on a float.
call me. Call me.
I gotta ask how much.
100.
Yeah.
Yes.
You had 25 on this. And it's got quite a bit of rust. Not a whole lot, but it's not perfect. The thermos has the thermos, but it's a little worn. That other box that we saw in Goshen was missing the handle, so I offered him 15, and then he said 20, and then I was like, eh, and he said 18, so I took it for 18. So, I've seen this same rainbow bright stuff at the same vendor twice a year since I started going for how many years, and it's always there, so I figured I'd offer her some reasonable price. This Slurpee drink maker, $2. Never used or opened, taken out. $2! Gonna make me some Slurpees.
Mm-hmm. trying to think of the one place where you can find him.
These guys is all marked at 24. I think I offered 15. I think settled on 20, maybe 18, I don't know. Some puzzles. Old Smurfs. All right. No thermos in the elf box. Went back later and got this Get Along Gang mug for $2. And I was walking away and saw another stack of puzzles. And he told me $10 for the stack, so I took it. Got Cinderella. Right. Like this guy had some maybe 10 old 80s LJN WWF wrestlers.
Sweet.
And he wanted $20 a piece for them. And I was like, I just got like 8 of them for $20 off eBay with shipping included. And he said, "What's eBay? Is that one of those computer things?" It's like, I don't do the computer.
$25, I can show you it works.
25?
Buy a new for 55 online. Then you gotta add shipping and handling.
Alright.
That one lights up cute, dark blue. Then you turn it on, you can put it on a flashlight.
These for 12. They were marked 5 each. I offered 10. He said, "How about 12? I said, "All right, fine. Have your $12. Got these 3 glasses for $5 towards the end of the day. Probably would have taken lower, but that's the way it goes. So I got this box of transformers and parts, and there's a few other things in here, like this He-Man vehicle that's missing some parts. So I found the box, and I asked the guy, "Well, how much do you want for just the whole box?" And he went and asked someone and came back and was like $50. So I was gonna start to look through it and decide whether that was something I wanted to take. And this kid comes up. He wants to look through it. He's got this fuzzy mustache. He wasn't even a gleam in his father's eye when this line was out. And he's digging. And I decided to be nice. I said, "Well, you can look, and if you you can go ahead. If you find anything, you're welcome to it before I decide to take this." I hadn't even looked through the box yet. So he's digging and pulls out several of them, and he's checking his phone to find all the accessories that go with each one that he wants or whatever, and he's taking forever. And he pulls out like half of all the figures and wants to pay $15, $20 for them. I'm like, "Well, the rest of the box isn't really worth that much to me. The guy wasn't gonna get his full $50. He puts one or two back and haggles the price and puts some more back. I think he ended up paying $15 for 3 or 4 of them, or maybe 5. But he started out with more than that, and he never offered more than like $20. At the end of it all, I was kind of aggravated with it, like, just being too nice. I should have just told the guy, "Okay, I'll take it. I'll take the box for $50 and tell that kid to put all the crap back." He ended up taking just a few of the better ones, I think. The kid paid $15. I think I ended up paying $30 because I think he only got $45 out of it after he split it up, and I got him to throw in those 3 strawberry shortcake glasses. I shouldn't have been so nice to this annoying kid.
$1. Just like new. So I got this lot for $20. I wonder what people think of me when I get Care Bears and Sesame Street and a bunch of punk CDs. What? 17 things for $20. A little over $1 each.
Got these 15 Holly Hobby glasses for $15. Said they wanted 25 for the set for all of them. I said 15. There's 5 of them doubles.
10 unique ones, 5 doubles. This guy did 12 on 4 glasses, and then he was doing 4 for a dollar Happy Meal toys. Beetleborgs, Nicktoons, Recess, Mighty Max, Rugrats, Crash Bandicoot, Knights of Tirnanog, Babe Goose.
It's
Babe Goose.
It's Ferdinand.
More Nickelodeon, Wild Thornberries. I was trying to find those guys, but didn't have them. Dexter's Lab, Rugrats, this weird cassette. Got this fairly kind of rusted, I don't know, what is that, sun faded Popples box. Thermos is in good condition, and a giant Pepsi glass for $7. This lady had 30 dollars marked on these, and I gave her 10 for them. She had to pay her daughter's car insurance. Went back at the end of the day, and these were still there, and she had 20 on all 4 of them. Said 10 for all 4. She probably would have went lower than that too. Since it seemed like she was entertaining all offers, I said I'd do a dollar a piece on the Muppet glasses. So I got 5 for 5. I got this E.T. for $4. It's shiny new 1982. I got the 3 for $12. 1988 from Burger King. This one's still got his paper tag on. Cookie? I got Cookie Monster Puppet for a dollar. $2, I got this 70s bank. And it had some tokens inside from Cherry Bowl in Rockford and Aladdin's Castle. I'm not sure where that one's from. If you know, tell me. Thundercats guy for a dollar. He was muddy. Had to give him a bath. Got 3 CDs for $5. Blondie, Feist, Morrissey. This was $5. I got a Fuzzy Splinter. And a Casey Jones. And a turtle cereal bowl. Deftones, White Pony, Genesis, We Can't Dance. I got the Stimpy for 50 cents. And the cake for free. Roaring 20s record. And a couple of Sesame Street Golden Books. Desert Blue VHS. I like that movie. $2! I got this junk for $5. Cabbage Patch Kids. Valentine's. From 92. Still sealed. Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. From Brown's Chicken. Star Trek Search for Spock Glass. Got this game. Puzzle. And some Doug Happy Meals. Recess. Knights of Tirnanog. She made it 7 even. At the end of the day, I got all these for $30. Probably could have went a little lower. She had these guys bagged for $8. I kind of went 4 on it. Probably could have got it for less. So I offered $2 a glass on all these. And she took it. This from a lady. She had 45 on the GameCube. She knew that was high. Offered 25 on all. Trying to do the 15 book complete set of encyclopedia for $7. And I said 5 for the games, so $12, and then 8 for the GameCube would have made it 20, and I think we ended on 25. So GameCube has had a game with it, and a card, a controller, and a PS2 power supply. So, kind of crummy on the system end, but not a bad deal. It's a pretty good deal. Got 4 Charlie Brown encyclopedias for $1. Couple of nice old ladies had these for $6.50. I didn't know these breakfast toys. I had a package promoting you to buy the cereal so you could get the free toys. I was $3.50, a little high, but I've never seen a package, so. And then she had 3 on these puzzles, but they were all packed together. I couldn't tell what ones were in them. She said they were all different, so. $6.50 for all of that.
Mail time. Mail time. The mail's here.
It's mail time again. Straight from Japan. Let's see.
finally got it open.
More stuff to cut.
...1987 from Japan. Robot Carnival soundtrack. Say what? Here's the inside. There's only one little surface scratch there. Probably the most I've paid for a single record as of yet.